God.
How to overcome depression. How to overcome depression. I'm going to just review what causes depression. We concluded that last week. I always like to conclude, to review, and then go to the next. Subtopic of today, powerful, is the mind and depression. The mind and depression. But before I get to that, I will go over what causes depression, because that is very important and is related to what I will be teaching today. Glory to God. It's related to what I will be teaching today. Glory to God. Amen. So let's share, and then let's have a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you, we bless you, we exalt your name. The great I am that I am, the first and the last, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega. God that was, he is, and he is to come. The unchangeable God. We commit this teaching and the preaching into your hands today. We pray for edification, exhortation, comfort, Father God, in the teaching of your word. In the name of Jesus, pray for deliverance even in the teaching of your word. Pray for salvation, for healing, for creative miracle in the teaching of your word. And by the power of the anointing, God, by the power of the shed blood, in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord God. We bless you, Lord God, that you will show up mightily today. In the name of Jesus, I bind every contrary spirit.
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus Christ, I release the anointing of God. I release the presence of God right now, right here, in the teaching of the word of God. No interference. In the name of Jesus, no confusion. In the name of Jesus. Pray for spirit of understanding, spirit of revelation, spirit of wisdom.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, I will pray, O Lord God, that the mystery of the gospel will be revealed to me even in the teaching of this message.
Yes,
in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Well, once again, we greet everyone and we welcome you to our online Bible study, online service. Glory to God.
Amen.
Last week, I concluded, what causes depression? What causes depression? I gave it 8 points. There were 8 points in case you don't have it. I'm going to go over it right now. If you want to write it down, it will be great. And if you have it, it will be great. And if you don't have it, or this is your first time you are viewing our service, online service, you can just make note. Number one, what causes depression? Circumstances beyond our control. That's number one. Circumstances beyond our control. Number two, depression comes when we lost something of great importance in our lives.
Yes.
Depression comes when we lost something of great importance in our life. Number three, depression is caused by generational causes. Depression is caused by generational causes. Number four, another reason for depression can be a chemical imbalance in the brain.
Yeah.
Number four, chemical imbalance in the brain. In this teaching, we talked about what causes chemical imbalance is negative thoughts. Negative thoughts, which we're going to be addressing a lot of that today. Negative thoughts. That's number four, chemical imbalance. Number five, I think that is sin is the main reason for depression.
Mm-hmm.
Sin is the main reason for depression. So sin causes depression. Mm-hmm. Number six, loneliness is another reason for depression. Mm-hmm. Loneliness is another reason for depression. We discussed last week that loneliness is not when you don't have physical or you don't have people around you. Loneliness caused by emptiness, because of emptiness in our heart. Mm-hmm. And the only person that can fill that emptiness is Jehovah God. God is the only one that can fill that loneliness. Loneliness is caused by dissatisfaction. By dissatisfaction, emptiness in our heart, and we became dissatisfied, and the only person that can fill that void, it is a void, is God. God is the only one that can fill that void. Number 7, depression is caused by physical illness. Depression is caused by physical illness. Number 8, low self-esteem is another cause of depression. That was the last one I gave last week. Loneliness is number 7. Self-esteem. Low self-esteem is another cause of depression. Glory to God. So now today, we're going to move into the new topic, the mind and depression. The mind and depression. So Father, we thank you. I'm going to read a few scriptures, then I will begin to teach. Romans 7:23. But I see another law in my members, warring against the law of my mind, and bringing me into captivity of the law of sin, which is my member. Bringing me into captivity to the law of sin, which is in my member. Romans 7:25. I thank God through Jesus Christ our Lord. So then, with the mind, I myself serve the law of God. But with the flesh, the law of sin. Now, let's also go to Romans 8:6-7. Romans 8:6-7. It says, for the carnally minded is dead, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Because the carnal mind is enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, nor indeed can be. Let's go to Romans 12:2. Romans 12:2, and do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable will of God. Proverbs 23:7. Proverbs 23:7. You say, for as he thinks in his heart, so is he. Eat and drinks. He says to you, but his heart is not with you. As stated, we learn that if we nurture negative thoughts in our mind, they produce stress in the brain. I stated in the past, that's why I gave the chemical imbalance. We talked about chemical imbalance last week, that when we nurture negative thought in our mind, they produce stress in the brain, provoking a chemical imbalance known today as depression. And this, you know, all the points that I gave you 8. This is the only physical cause. This is the only physical cause. The others are spiritual or mental or emotional, you know. So as stated, when we nurture negative thought in our mind, mind is very important. We need to protect our mind. We have to be careful what we listen to, right. what we watch, who is talking yes, to us, who is teaching us, mm-hmm. who do you associate with that mm-hmm. always feeds you? Because if we nurture negative thoughts in our mind, it produces stress in the brain, which provokes a chemical imbalance known today as depression. Mm-hmm. This is how the psychiatric and the psychologist and the doctor thinks. But what does the Word of God say about our thought and depression? We can see in Proverbs 23, he says, "For as he thinks in his heart, mm-hmm. as you think in his heart, so is he." Mm-hmm. So whatever you're thinking in your heart, that's who you are. That's what you are going to do. Now, there are three things regarding thoughts. Three things regarding thoughts. Number one, the way we think of ourselves is the way we act and behave. Mm-hmm. The way we think about ourselves is the way we act and we think. And that's what the Bible says in Proverbs 23:7. "For as he thinks in his heart, so is he." So is he. So the way we think of ourselves is the way we act and is the way we are going to behave. In other words, as a man thinks of himself in his heart, this is the way he is. If you think it's ugly, he will act accordingly. If you think you are ugly, you will act accordingly with those around you. Mm. You will feel insecure when people look at you. When people look at you, you feel insecure and assume that people judge you because of your outer appearance.
Okay. Teach
when they look at you, say, "Oh, now they're looking at me because I'm ugly." Because that's what you think in your mind.
Yes.
But they might not be looking at you. They have something different
yes.
to you. They might have even a good news for
exactly.
you. But you will assume that they are judging you because of your outer appearance.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, remember the first one, the way we think of ourselves is the way we act and behave.
Oh, really
number
good.
Two, really thoughts good. Result in action.
Mm-hmm.
Thoughts result in action.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, whatever you're thinking, that's what you're going to do. Whatever thought you harbor in your mind, that's what you are going to do. According to the seriousness of this thought, it will be easy to see a strong relationship with thought and action.
Mm-hmm.
There's a strong relationship with thought and action.
Mm-hmm.
What you think, that's what you will do. What you're doing, that's what you have been thinking.
Mm-hmm.
That's what you have been thinking. So we constantly remember, if you constantly remember the pain people cause you, guess what is going to happen? You want to revenge. Vengeance will come to you. That's why when people hurt you, you want to forgive them and you want to take that off of your mind.
Mm-hmm.
If you continue to remember that or you continue to nurture that thought, guess what? You going to eventually revenge. Are you hearing me? You're going to eventually revenge. Glory to God.
Yes.
So thought result in action.
Mm-hmm.
Thoughts result in action. So we have to be careful what we are thinking. What are you thinking now? What are you nurturing in your mind?
Mm-hmm.
If it's good, it will produce good results.
Yes, sir.
But if it's bad, it's going to produce bad results.
Yes.
Amen. So if you want good results, begin to think something positive
mm-hmm.
and nothing negative.
Be around
Amen?
Positive people.
Be around positive people,
mm-hmm.
people that will encourage you,
yes.
people that will motivate you,
yes.
glory to God,
uplift you.
People that will uplift you,
yes.
hallelujah. Guess what? When they uplift you, guess what will happen? You know, you will begin to think positively in your mind,
yes.
and that's what you are going to do. glory to God. Amen. So thought result in action.
Yes.
Thought result in action. That's number two. Number three, our thoughts affect our emotion in a positive or negative way. Our thoughts affect our emotions in a positive or negative way. So we can summon these three. Let's go over this again. The three, number one, the way we think of ourselves is the way we act and behave. Mm-hmm. Number two, thought results in actions. Thought results in action. What you think, that's what you're going to do. Mm-hmm. What you are doing, that's what you've been thinking.
Mm-hmm.
Number three, our thought affect our emotions in a positive or negative way.
Mm-hmm.
In a positive or negative way. So we can summon these three, as if you play around with, entertain, and allow bad thoughts in your mind, we eventually become what we think. I'm going to go over that again. The three thoughts I have given to you, if we summon everything together, the three together, means if we play around, entertain and allow thought, negative thought in our mind or positive thought in our mind, whatever we entertain, whatever we play around with in our mind, either bad or good, we will eventually become what we think. If you think positively, you will become positive. You get a positive result. If you think negatively, you will get a negative result. So mind is not something we need to play with. Amen? So if we are constantly thinking, we are going to get sick. Guess what?
Eventually
you will get sick.
If you continually
thinking, you are going to get divorced. You are married. You are always thinking you're going to get divorced. Guess what? It will happen. Once thoughts become rooted,
mm-hmm.
are you hearing me? When once thought become rooted
mm-hmm.
in our mind, it affects our emotion.
Mm-hmm.
It affects our emotion. Amen? How does that happen? When it's rooted, what it would do, if it's negative thought, it makes us feel dirty. It make us feel bad.
Mm-hmm.
It make us feel rejected.
Lord,
it make us feel miserable. It make us look stupid, worthless, and incapable of doing anything. Then finally, we begin to act stupid. You remember you are thinking, it make us feel dirty, as if we are bad. It feel, make us feel dirty, make us feel bad. Make us feel rejected,
mm-hmm.
make us feel miserable, make us feel stupid, make us feel worthless
mm-hmm.
and incapable of doing anything.
Mm-hmm.
Until finally, we begin to act stupid.
Mm-hmm.
We begin to act worthless. We begin to be rejected
mm-hmm.
and so forth and go on. It starts in the mind.
Mm-hmm.
It starts in the mind and then it will affect your emotion
mm-hmm.
and begin to affect your action.
Lord,
are you
Lord,
hearing
Lord,
me?
Lord.
Amen. So we've given two types of thoughts. Thoughts. What we have to know about thoughts. Now, let's go to Matthew 16. Matthew 16, we're going to read 13 to 17, then we're going to go to Matthew 16, 21 to 23. Then I'm going to share three sources of thoughts, three sources of thought. Now, so let's go to Matthew 16, 13. When Jesus came to the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, Who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? So they say, some say John the Baptist, some Elijah, and other Jeremiah or one of the prophets. He said to them, but who do you say that I am? Simon Peter answered and said, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Then Jesus replied him, Jesus answered and said to him, blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jona, for flesh and blood have not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven. My Father who is in heaven. Now, let's go to the same Matthew 16, verse 21 to 23. For that time, Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things from the elder and chief priests and scribes, and be killed, and be raised the third day. Then Peter, the same Peter, then Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him, saying, far be it from you, Lord, this shall not happen to you. But he turned and said to Peter, get behind me, Satan. Remember, Peter is the one that rebuked Jesus. But Jesus turned around and rebuked him. But when Jesus turned around and rebuked him, he said, get behind me, Satan. He didn't say, get behind me, Peter. He said, get behind me, Satan. You are an offense to me. Now, Peter facing him, is looking into Peter's face, into Peter's eye, but he was rebuking Satan. He was rebuking Satan. Then he continued. He said, you are an offense to me, for you have not mindful of the things of God, but the things of men. This is very interesting that the first time Jesus had the question, Jesus asked them, who do people say I am? And it's a prophet, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, whatever. No, they mentioned other names. And then Peter came and Peter said, no, you are the Son of the living God.
Yes, sir.
In other words, you are the Messiah. And Jesus said, whoa, flesh and blood have not revealed this to you.
No.
In other words, this did not come from you. In other words, this comes as a thought, but this is not your thought.
Wow.
This is coming from God.
Lord.
You see, sometimes God speaks to us, he put words in our mind. And when we speak it, we think it's our thought.
Yes, sir.
But what that's what Jesus was telling Peter. You know, sometimes you don't come into your spirit, you don't see a vision, but sometimes prophetic word come into your mind. And when you come into your mind, it will seem as if it is your thought.
Yes.
It seems as if you are the one speaking this. And that's what Jesus told Peter. Said, whoa, this is not flesh and blood. This thought is not human thought. This thought is not coming from you, Peter. This is revelation.
In other words,
my Father in heaven put it in your mind. And you spoke it, but it's not your thought. It's not coming from you. And he said, flesh and blood did not reveal this to you. You didn't know this by yourself. This is revelation. My Father in heaven
give you this revelation.
Now, few minutes later, the same Peter, when Jesus was sharing to them that he would die, he would go on the cross, he would die, and on the third day, he would resurrect. Peter put Jesus on the side. And he began to rebuke Jesus. He said, you are not going to die. You are not going to the cross. And Jesus turned around and rebuked, not Peter, but he rebuked Satan. This what we call the law of double reference. The law of double reference. In other words, Peter was the one that rebuked Jesus. But when Jesus turned around to rebuke Peter, Jesus did not call Peter. Jesus called Satan.
Yes.
So, in hindsight, Jesus was rebuking two persons.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in the law of double reference, there's a primary reference and there's a secondary reference.
The first reference Jesus
was addressing is the person that we call his name.
Yes.
He said, "Get behind me, Satan." But Peter was in front of him. Then, is he calling Peter Satan? Or is he calling Satan Satan? Well, he's calling Satan Satan because Satan influenced. The same way God put thought in our mind is the same way the devil will put thought also in your mind, and you will think it's you. But it's not you. It's the devil put that thought in you. And that's why if you harbor negative thought that the enemy put in you, you will begin to act negatively. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Now, three sources of thoughts. There are three sources of thoughts. These sources of thought that influence us positively and negative way. Three sources of thoughts that influence us in positive and negative ways. Number one, man. That's what Jesus told Peter. It's not flesh and blood. This is not coming from you. This is not your thought.
Mm-hmm.
My Father in heaven put this thought in you. But it looked as if, that's how it would look as if it's coming from you. And that's why devil put a lot of thought in a lot of people's mind.
Mm-hmm.
All this racism and the bigotry and the systemic racism that is going on is the devil that implanted that in them. It's a rooted thought in their mind. Are you hearing me? Now, let's go back to three sources of thought. Number one, man. Number two, devil. Mm-hmm. Number three, God. So the first person is man, the second, devil, the third is God.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Now, where does the bad thought come from? The bad thought did not come from man. Bad thought comes from the enemy. It's what he introduced to us. The enemy makes sure that these bad thoughts come into our lives, making us thinking in the first person. In other words, making us thinking that this thought is coming from us. So when the devil put thought in your mind, he don't bring it into your mind and said, "I am the devil, this thought is coming from me." No, he don't do that. The devil will put the thought in you, make it look as if it is your thought. And that's why, also, the same way God will put thought in our mind, and sometimes we don't know, we think this thought is ours.
Yes.
But not knowing is coming from God. And that's what happened to Peter when Peter told Jesus that you are the Son of God. You are the Son of God. Quickly, because of discernment. Jesus used the gift of discernment and told Peter right there, "No, this is not you. This thought was put in your mind by my Father in heaven. So this is a revelation, not your thought."
Yes.
So the enemy makes sure that the bad thoughts come into our lives, make us think is the first person.
Mm-hmm.
What that means is the first person is, he put it in our mind and make it think this thought is coming from us. But these thoughts are not coming from us. In other words, it makes us believe that this thought is ours, when in reality is not our thought. And thank God for gift of discernment. Jesus discerned the two times thought was put in Peter's mind. Mm-hmm. The first time, he said, "You are the Christ." The second, that Jesus told him right away that flesh and blood did not reveal this to you. Mm-hmm. In other words, God put that thought in him. He spoke it out. Looks as if it was his thought, but yes, it was not his thought. And Jesus caught that. And Jesus told him, this is not your thought. Mm. This is coming from my Father in heaven.
My Lord, my Lord.
Secondly, when Jesus said he was going on the cross, Peter was rebuking him. Mm-hmm. And Jesus turned around by discernment and said, this also is not coming from you. This also is not coming from you. Mm-hmm. This is coming from Satan, and he rebuked Satan. Actually, the rebuke, that's what we call the law of double reference, when you use one rebuke, but you are referring to two people. So what does that mean? Because he is the devil influenced him, he also rebuked Peter. In other words, why do you allow the devil to influence you? The law of double reference. So sometimes this thought will come to us. The bad thought is not from God. We know that, obviously. Sometimes it's not from us. It's from the devil. But it will make it to look as if it's our thought.
Yes.
Because if the devil introduce himself to you and say, "Okay, my name is Satan and I'm going to give you this thought. Or my name is Lucifer and I put it in your mind to go do this." You won't do it.
No.
But some things he put in our mind. And it makes us believe these thoughts are ours, when it's in reality, they are not our thought. It's not our thought. Mm-hmm. So the source of thoughts that influence us in positive or negative ways are man. That's the first person. Devil. Second, God. Thought. Now, I does not say, "Oh man, I am the devil." He will not say that.
Mm-mm.
Now, because this strategy, there's the strategy of the enemy to kill, to steal, and destroy. We can say that the enemy sends an arrow of thought into our mind.
Mm-hmm.
An arrow of thought. The scripture called it fiery dot.
Mm-mm-mm-mm.
It sends the fiery dot in our mind to influence us. This makes us feel bad. It affects our emotion, our will,
yes,
and make us feel weak.
Yes.
Those thoughts make us feel weak. Those thoughts affect our emotion, and it makes us feel bad.
Yes, yes, yes.
Now, the mind, which we all know this, the mind is the devil's battleground,
mm-hmm,
where it sends all negative and destructive thought. The mind is the devil's battleground, where it sends all negative and destructive thought. Now, today, let's go once again to the Word of God. Let's go to 2 Corinthians.
Mm-hmm.
2 Corinthians 10:5. 2 Corinthians 10:5. Mm-hmm. It says, "Casting down arguments and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ." Casting down argument and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God.
Mm-hmm.
Bringing every thought into captivity of the obedience of Christ.
Right.
Now, I want to talk to you about, this is a subtopic as well, mental stronghold.
Yes, sir.
mental stronghold. What is mental stronghold? Mental stronghold is an established thought in the predisposed mind. Mental stronghold is an established thought. In other words, thought that has been established in your mind. Now, there's some thoughts that comes to us, it's not yet established. There's some thoughts that come that we're still struggling with. Well, is this God? Or is this me? Or is this the devil? But mental stronghold is not that. Mental stronghold is an established thought in a predisposed mind. That means whatever it is has been established in your mind. Whatever it has been established, you believe it, and you are acting it. Now, I will give that again. Mental stronghold, it is an established thought in a disposed mind, impregnated with hopelessness, causing a person to accept the event as something that can never be changed.
My.
Mental stronghold. I'm going to repeat that again. This is going to help us in this teaching. This is going to help us how we deal with issues in our life. This is going to help us to eradicate some thought from our mind that is not from God. So mental stronghold. It's an established thought in a predisposed mind impregnated with hopelessness, causing the person to accept events as something that cannot be changed.
So in other words, like accept like defeat. Like
accept defeat.
It's not going
to... I'm not going to be like someone says, I'm not going to be successful in life.
Okay.
I'm not going to be successful in life.
Yes.
That means that thought has been established in their mind.
Jesus.
It's been established in a predisposed mind.
God.
Impregnated with hopelessness.
Teach that thing.
Impregnated with hopelessness. Causing a person to accept any events surrounding them. So, in other words, the Bible says, I'm not going to make it. It's already established in their mind. It doesn't matter what you tell them. It doesn't matter what you preach to them. It doesn't matter what you taught them. Because in their mind, it's already established and they are impregnated with hopelessness that they will never make it.
Jesus.
Oh, God of heaven, help us. Now today we're going to understand some things why some people cannot change.
My God.
We're going to understand some things why some people, you tell them and tell them and tell them and tell them and you're still telling them, but they're not changing. Because it's a mental stronghold that they have. The thought has been established in their mind.
My God.
And they have impregnated with hopelessness. It leads to depression. They've accepted defeat. What can you tell to somebody that's already accepted defeat? It's established in their mind and impregnated with hopelessness. No, this can't change. It can't happen.
Wow.
No, it's not going to happen. Oh, I am weak. And it's already established in their mind. Mind is a terrible thing to lose. Mind is very important. That's why in the element our weapon, according to Ephesians 6, the most important there is element of salvation. Without your head, without your mind, you don't have sense of direction. Very, very important. Now, as we already know, one cause of depression is experiencing circumstances that is beyond our control. Actually, that's number one. Out of the 8 points, the causes of depression, number one is circumstances beyond our control. So a stronghold arises up in our mind of a person who believes his situation is impossible to change. So someone that have a mental stronghold, they've already believed that it is impossible for their situation to change.
Change, wow.
It lost all hope for living and gives up. Now it feels depression. Mm. And that's how depression comes, because this person in their mind is already established. The thought have been established in their mind, impregnated with hopelessness. Mm. They are already sent in their mind. There is no change. I don't have control over this situation. Then it leads to depression.
Uh-huh.
It leads to hopelessness, and it leads to depression because the situation is beyond his control. As I said earlier, last week, we like to be in control. We love to be in control. When we lose control, anxiety comes, hopelessness comes, and those two open doors to what? To depression. To depression. And that's how people get depressed, because in their mind, the thought has been established in their predisposed mind, impregnated with hopelessness, and they have made up their mind that this situation cannot change. That means they've lost control of that situation. That leads to depression. Mm-hmm. Now,
My Lord.
We're going to continue. What elements contribute to making of stronghold in our mind? In other words, what element contribute to mental stronghold?
Yes.
It's very important for us to know this. This will really help us. This will really help us to reject some thoughts that is negative. Thoughts that are not of God.
Mm-hmm.
We have to reject that, right? Now, what elements contribute to the making of strongholds in our mind?
Mm-hmm.
Number one, arguments. Arguments. Even you will see 2 Corinthians 10:5 says, casting down arguments.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Argument, we got to cast it down. And everything that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. Mm. Argument. Please note this.
Cast it down right away.
Cast it down right away. Don't tolerate it. Don't entertain it.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, if you entertain it, it will be established in your mind.
Ah.
And when it's established in your mind, it leads to hopelessness. You become impregnated with what? Hopelessness.
Jesus.
And when hopelessness set in, guess what? Hopelessness opened the door for depression to come in.
Mm.
That's how it goes. It goes from anxiety and hopelessness opened the door for what? For depression to come in.
So that's when, so spirit of heaviness just walk in as well.
Everything, everybody walk in. Everybody, because the door is open, man.
The door is open.
When the door is open, then everything will begin to come in.
So interesting, boy.
Not only spirit of heaviness walking, when spirit of heaviness walking, the next one that's going to walk in is a deaf and dumb spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Suicidal.
Condemnation, wow.
Yeah, condemnation, that is a evidence.
Mm-hmm.
Condemnation is evidence. And then when you get too heavy, you say, no, well, there's no more hope for me.
Hopelessness.
There's no reason for me to leave.
Mm.
Let me take my life. That's how people take their life.
Mm.
Because they lost control of their situation. And because some of them, the negative thought that have been established in their predisposed mind, then it leads to impregnated with what? Hopelessness. Then depression comes in. Now, let's go back here. What elements contribute to the making of strongholds in our mind? Number one, arguments. What is arguments? Argument is that the person is constantly arguing, even after being told that the problem or the situation can change. His response or her response is no, this is impossible to change. Listen to me, God is able to change any situation.
Yes,
there's no situation that's bigger to our God.
Mm-hmm.
Glory to God. So argument, what is argument? A person who is constantly arguing, even after being told that the problem or circumstances can change. His response is, or our response is no. It is impossible to change.
No, Lord.
That's the first element that lead to stronghold.
Mm-hmm.
That lead to mental stronghold. I have a news for you. There's no situation that my God cannot change.
Ah.
My God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all you think or ask.
That's
according
right. That's right.
to the power
That's
that
right.
worketh in you.
That's right.
God is able to solve your problem.
Yes.
God is able to change that situation. Hallelujah. So arguments, people that always be, oh no, I don't think it's going to change. It happened to Sister Sue. It happened to Brother Mike. It happened to this. It never changed. No, God can change it. It might not change for them. I don't know who they serve. I don't know where they believe in. But God can change any and every situation that you are going through right now. It doesn't matter what. It doesn't matter how long you've been going through it. My God is able to do it.
Yes, sir.
He can change it. Glory
yes,
to God.
Yes,
even my God can change a king for you to change your situation.
Yes.
He can move a king. He can move a president.
Yes.
He can move a government to change your situation.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
If God say, I'm going to change it, he is able. Hallelujah.
Yes.
He is man that able to change that situation. I don't know what situation you are going through right now. My God, don't argue. Don't say no. Cast down argument.
Mm.
Pull down argument.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. And that's what the Bible says. That's what the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 10:5. He said, cast it down. Don't argue. God say, I'm going to do it. Cast down arguments. And everything that exalts itself more than the knowledge of God.
Mm.
Oh, God of heaven. He will do it. He can do it. He has done it before.
Yeah.
He will do it again.
That's right.
Immutability of God. He changes now.
Yes.
He's God of yesterday, today, and forever.
Yes.
What he did last week, he can do it again.
Yes.
What he did in the Bible, he can do even now.
Yes.
Hallelujah. It doesn't matter what dispensation we are in.
Mm.
My God, oh, I feel like preaching now.
Oh,
my
preach.
God is able to do exceedingly abundantly.
Yes.
He will change that situation.
Yes.
It doesn't matter what is going on in the universe. It doesn't matter what is going on in America.
Yes,
he will change it and change it and change it and change it. And he's still changing
yes,
it.
Sir.
Glory be to God.
Yes, sir.
Oh!
Hallelujah.
Argument. Yeah.
My,
if God says he's going to do it, don't argue. He will do it. Don't consider it. No, he's yes.
Mm-hmm.
He's able to do it.
Yes,
all you need to do is just believe.
Yes, sir.
Believe.
Yes, sir.
Trust in him.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. He can do it again. There's a song. If he did it before, he can do it again.
That's right.
Same God. He's the same God. He has not changed. Glory to God.
My Lord.
Argument. That's what leads number one cause of mental stronghold. mental stronghold. There's some things we got to change in our mind.
Yes, yes, yes.
We have to reprogram our mind.
Mm-hmm.
Because mental stronghold, let me go back there again, because I truly believe this is very, very important. And that's why a lot of us are not getting our breakthrough. Because there's an established thought in our mind,
mm-hmm.
impregnated with hopelessness.
Mm-hmm.
When we change that, you will see breakthrough will begin to come your way.
Yes,
it is
yes.
possible. God is able to do it. God can do it.
Mm-hmm.
He will do it. If he says he's going to do it, he's going to do it. It's not a God to lie. It is impossible for God to lie. Mm-hmm. Everything about God is truth.
Something that you
Nebo Sakaya
saying, you said arguments, arguments.
Argument.
And this is it. It takes two to argue.
Argument.
So when you're arguing, I mean, the enemy is trying to convince you of his side.
Argument.
He's trying to change your mind.
Argument.
And you have to say, no, I'm not going to
argue. Actually, the argument, not that the devil is trying to change your mind. Argument means the devil have already changed your mind.
Already changed your mind.
Because we're talking about mental stronghold.
Mm.
Mental stronghold is an established thought.
Mm-hmm.
That means the thought that it will not change have already been established in your mind.
Yes.
So in other words, the devil got your mind. Mm-hmm. Not that he will get it, because that thought already established in your mind.
Mm.
If it hasn't been established, good.
Aha.
You can fight it.
Yes.
You can reject it.
Yes.
But these have already been established.
For many, it's already
so what I'm teaching right now are the elements that contribute to argument.
Mm.
That means it's already been established in your mind.
Mm.
So this person, let me give you the definition of arguments again.
Mm.
The person is constantly arguing. Not with the devil.
Mm-hmm.
Not with the negative thought. Because the negative thought have already been established.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Are you hearing me? The negative thought has already been established. So argument, the person is constantly arguing, even being told the problems and the circumstances will change. Their response is no. They've already believed the thought has been established in them. They've already believed that the situation cannot change. So what they're doing now, if you come to me and tell me your situation will change, I'm telling you, no, it cannot change.
Mm-hmm.
So I mean, the thought has come into their mind. The devil has put the thought into their mind.
Mm-hmm.
The thought has already been established
mm-hmm.
in their mind.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing you're going to do for them to believe what you're saying.
So it's a seed that was planted some time ago.
It's been planted.
It's rooted.
It's been rooted.
Glory to God.
It's growing.
And it's growing, exactly.
So you cannot say, then you come to me and say, no, this is possible. No, it's not possible.
Wow. Wow.
So they are not arguing with the enemy.
Wow.
The enemy has already planted that thought
did
in
work.
Them.
Ah. Wow.
So arguments,
Mm-mm-mm-mm.
and that's what we say, argument. Cast it down.
That's right, sir.
Argument,
Jesus.
The person is constantly arguing.
Mm-mm-mm.
Even after being told the problem or circumstances or situation can be changed, his response is no, this is impossible to change.
Jesus.
That's number one argument. We're talking about the elements that contribute to struggle in our mind. Number two, imagination. Imagination. People with negative strongholds continually nurture negative thoughts. Imagination.
Mm.
People with negative strongholds continually nurture negative thoughts. That can be dangerous because when we nurture negative thoughts, it leads to chemical imbalance
wow.
and in the brain. And chemical imbalance actually is the only physical cause of depression. People with negative strongholds continually nurture negative thoughts.
Mm.
As believers, we don't want to nurture negative thought.
Yes, sir.
When you nurture negative thought, even I just give you three things you know about thought. Whatever you think, that's what you're going to do. Our thought change our emotions. Now, so imagination, people with negative strongholds mm-hmm. continually nurture negative thought. As I said before, one of the causes of depression is chemical imbalance. So negative thoughts leads to chemical imbalance in our brain. It leads to stress in our brain. And that is chemical imbalance, and that becomes stress. So number one, number two is imagination. Number three is ideas.
My.
Ideas. In other words, different type of negative ideas. Different types of negative ideas. Number four, arrogance. I'm going to go over this again. This is Bible study. I'm going to go over this. We got to get this. We have to get this. This will really help us in life, in decision making, in what we do, not to allow all this negative thought to be established, mm-hmm. not to nurture negative thought. This is very powerful. Mind is a terrible thing to lose. Now, so ideas. Different types of negative ideas. The next one is arrogance. Arrogance, we know that. Not trusting in the Lord. Only trusting in ourselves.
Good God Almighty.
Arrogance.
Leads to trouble.
Arrogance. Not trusting in the Lord. As believer, we have to trust in the Lord every time. Every day, every hour, every minute, every second, we have to trust in the Lord.
That's right.
Arrogance is not trusting in the Lord, only trusting in ourselves.
Yes, sir.
Trusting in ourselves. Are you still with me? Let me go back to the top. Number one, arguments. Number two, imagination. Mm-hmm. Number three, ideas. Number four, arrogance. Mm-hmm. Arrogance, not trusting in the Lord, only trusting in self. Mm-hmm. Amen. Let us always trust in God. God is our helper. Glory to God. Let's put our trust in God. Those that don't trust in the Lord, it leads to what? To mental strongholds.
Mm.
It leads to mental strongholds. Number four. No, number five. Is that five? One, two, three. I didn't number them. One, two, three, four, five. Number five. Mental structures.
Mm.
Mental structures. What is that? People do not accept anything. Even though you are only desired to guide them
mm-hmm.
and to answer to their problems, people with mental structure have a difficult time accepting direction because their mind is closed.
Jesus help.
Mental structure.
Jesus.
I'll give a very good example. A few years ago when Pastor Marshall and I went to go cancel somebody. I will tell you about this. You probably know where I'm going.
I know exactly.
But mental structure. People do not accept anything. Even though you are desiring or you are trying to guide them to the answer of their problem. You are trying to help them. People with mental structures have a difficult time accepting direction, accepting instructions
mm-hmm.
because their mind are closed. Years ago, we just started the ministry, and this lady was having big problems. So at the time, we don't have an office where to counsel her. So we decided, we're going to, you know, go to her house, sit down with her, and counsel her. So we got there, we sat down, and she sat down too. I hope you remember that.
Of course.
Do you believe? I don't even remember if I finished a sentence in that house. Every time I tried to begin to talk, to share, open to help
word,
her,
open
the word of God, she will interject.
Yes.
She will interject. She will say this. She will say that. She will say this. She will say that. Do you believe I never had the chance to open my Bible and have the opportunity to share with her what the Lord is saying,
the
what
situation.
Is written in regards to her situation?
Yes.
And matter of fact, she talk. I feel as if I came for counseling. No, I'm serious. And that's how I felt. That came for, it got to a point, I just closed my Bible,
yes,
I put it in my briefcase, I just relax and begin to listen. But now I realize, you know, our mind is closed.
Yes.
Completely closed.
Yes.
She's not receiving what we have to say. She talked too much. She's not receiving what we have to say.
No.
And we came to help you.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a good example of mental structure. Even though you're trying to help them, they don't follow instruction, they don't listen to you, because their minds
closed.
Are closed.
Closed.
Mental structure.
Hers was closed completely.
Was closed. I realized that. At the early stage, I tried.
I was about to say.
I just closed my Bible.
Yeah.
I put it in my briefcase.
Yeah.
I crossed my leg and I began to listen.
Until we left.
Until we say, ma'am, I think it's time we are going to start going right now.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, okay, thank you for coming.
Yes.
We did not accomplish anything.
Even
we were there.
For a couple hours.
Couple hours. You're told, go from one place to another.
All of
it's
what
closed.
She's going through, I mean, you know.
In her mind.
Yeah, yeah.
And the mind is closed to receive anything.
Very, very, very closed.
Oh, God, I pray you won't go through that. I pray
yes.
you are not going through that.
Yes.
Mental structure.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the next one. Idiosyncrasy.
Mm-hmm.
Idiosyncrasy.
Mm-hmm.
People say to themselves, this is what my mother taught me. This is what my grandmother taught me. This is what my father taught me.
Yes.
This is what my grandfather taught me. This is what my great, 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 and great father taught me. And this is the way I'm going to be. And this is the way I'm going to die. Idiosyncrasy is also a very strong mental stronghold that people believe what their parents have taught them, even though it's negative. And that's one of the reasons we are going through all over the world, this racism, social injustice, systemic racism,
mm-hmm.
even systemic poverty
My
is
Lord
because
Jesus.
Of idiosyncrasy.
Yes, sir.
People already believe because of the skin of your color, you are dumb.
No, the color of
your
skin.
The color of your skin. The
mm-hmm.
color of your skin, you are dumb. Because of the color of your skin, I am better than you.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the color of your skin. Skin, I am superior and you are inferior.
Ah.
It's what we call idiosyncrasy. They learn this in their home. That's
Woo.
What their father told them. That's what their grandfather
help
told
God,
them.
Help.
That's what their mother
help.
Told them. That's what their grandmother
help.
Told them. That's what their great, great,
help.
Great, great,
help.
Great grandmother
help.
Told
help.
Them. It's a idiosyncrasy, the way they were taught in the family, and it's difficult for them to change.
Jesus, my God in heaven.
And that's why people like that, it's very difficult to change them. All these elements that I gave, I believe I just gave six. Let me just go over it again. I know I was teaching and preaching. Number one, we're talking about what elements contribute to the making of strongholds in our mind. arguments, imagination, ideas, arrogance, mental structures, idiosyncrasy. Idiosyncrasy is people say to themselves, this is what my grandmother, my father, my mother taught me, and this is where it is. And this is where it's going to be. God, and there will be no change.
God help.
It leads also to depression.
Yeah.
It leads to anxiety, hopelessness, and depression. God is able to change that. Mind need to be renewed. So this element causes a mental stronghold to rise in our minds or in the minds of people, making them think that everything is hopeless. These six make them think everything is hopeless. And when you feel that everything is hopeless, guess what? You lose control of that situation.
Yes.
And when you lose control of that situation, depression comes in. A stronghold separates. This is very important, God's people. A stronghold separates people from the knowledge of God.
Yes, sir.
A stronghold separates people from the knowledge of God. It blocked them from obeying his word and resisting change, even though it is for their benefit. I'll give you another example. Years ago, there was a prophet. When we first started the ministry, we started in the house in Bowie, Maryland. I won't mention his name. A prophet came, actually from another country, to America, and the Lord told him to come join us, and he and his wife, and they came. But one thing he told me, he said, when he was coming to us, the Lord told him that everything that he know, he had to put it on the side and to submit himself. No, it's true. God, most people have problems to submitting because of the false teaching that they have is already established in their mind. So it doesn't matter what you teach them, what you tell them, they will not believe it. It's already established. This is how my old pastor used to tell me.
Yeah.
That's what my old pastor said it is.
Yeah.
When I was young, going to church with my family, that's what they said it is, and that's what it is.
Yes, sir.
When he was coming, God said, take all of the things you have learned, put it on the side, go to this man and woman of God and submit yourself and learn.
Idiosyncrasy.
You know, it was already established in his mind, wrong teaching. So God wants to change that wrong teaching. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So a stronghold separates people from the knowledge of God. It blocked them from obeying his word and resisting change, even though it's for their benefit. Depression begins when people lost hope in life. When people lost hope in life, depression begins. Now, let's go to Ephesians 2:12. Ephesians 2:12. What does the word of God say about the way the world is? Another thing we want to know, remember we see our problem from the human standpoint of views. But it's good to invite God into our problem. So we can begin to see it in another view, which is in the spiritual view, in God's view. Now, when you see, let's go to Romans 2:12. Is it that at the time you are without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel and strangers from the covenants of promise. Mm-hmm. Having no hope.
My Lord Jesus.
Having no hope. Mm-hmm. And without God, there's no hope in the world. Mm-hmm. He said, having no hope and without God in the world. The world lives without hope or God. Mm-hmm. A world without God is lost and on a straight road to destruction.
Good God Almighty. Wow.
So in other words, whatever situation we are going through, we always see it in a human standpoint. Mm-hmm. We have to invite God into that situation. For God to shed his light in that situation. Mm-hmm. You know, with God, there's no hopelessness.
That's right.
In God, there's always answer and result to our problem.
Yes, sir.
Because when we have problem, we focus and we look at it on a human standpoint. Mm-hmm. So whatever situation you're going through right now that want to lead to depression, before you give up, I'm telling you, invite God to come to that situation.
Yes, sir.
Invite Jehovah. Hallelujah. Wow. Before you say, oh, I'm losing control. Oh, it's hopeless. No, it's not hopeless. It's hopeless because you are viewing your situation based on human standpoint. What is God saying about that situation? I'm telling you, I'm challenging you right now to invite God to your situation. Because in this world, without God, everything is hopeless. Hallelujah. But with God, all things are possible. All things are possible. Glory to God. So what do we need to do? What do we need to do? We need to invite God into our situation. All we need to do is just trust him. Invite him and trust him. Now, let's go to Mark. Let's go to Mark 10:27. Mark 27, I'm trying to complete this week. So next week we can focus and begin to teach how to overcome depression. How to overcome depression. Mm-hmm. Amen. All we've been doing is just preparation to know what the depression is, to know what causes depression, to know the symptoms of depression.
Yes.
We've addressed all of that. Yes. Then starting next week, I'll try to finish this today. Starting next week, we begin to deal how to overcome depression. Amen. Now let's go to Mark 10:27. Remember Ephesians 12, what that says? The world is without hope and without God. We don't want to live like the world, the way the world lives. We want to invite God to our situation. Whatever is your challenge, whatever you are going through right now, don't give up. Don't lose hope. Invite God. Invite Jehovah God. Amen. You are just focusing on one view, on a human standpoint. We need to shift and see what God's saying about this. When God steps in, hallelujah, every problem will be solved.
Yeah.
Amen. Glory to God. We are no longer stranger. Hallelujah. We are in covenant with God. Hallelujah. By the blood of Jesus, we are in covenant with God. So invite God to that situation, and you see that situation will be solved. Hallelujah. God have his own standpoint. Amen. Don't give up just on your own standpoint. Invite God to come
That's
in.
Right, sir.
Hallelujah.
That's
Glory
right.
to God. And God will solve that problem no matter what.
Yes, sir.
Abel. Hallelujah. When you read in the Bible, you will see his resume. He has done it before. He can do it again. If he did it before, he can do it again, again and again and again. Glory to God. Without fail. Thank you. Without fail. He never fail. Amen. It is impossible for God to fail.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. How can a creator fail? Fail to who? To creation? No. He cannot fail. It is impossible for God to fail. Hallelujah. Go in the Bible and check up his resume. Glory to God. His resume is in the word of God. Hallelujah. Mark 10:20. What do we do? If you go into this issue. Mark 10:27. But Jesus looked and Jesus looked at them and said, with men it is impossible, but not with God. For with God, all things are possible.
Come on and talk, sir.
Hallelujah. I don't know what's your situation. What's leading to depression?
My Lord, my Lord.
God is able to solve it.
Yes, sir.
With man, it is impossible. But with God, all things are possible. God is able to solve your problem. Glory to God. Even in the situation the whole world is in. You will see all the president, the nation president, the prime minister, the governors, the mayor. They are looking all this thing in the world in a human standpoint.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. But God have his own view. Glory to God.
Lord,
that's
Lord.
Why we should invite God to come in.
Yes, sir.
For God to come in into this situation. He will give us a solution that will never fail.
Mm-hmm.
Glory to God. He will solve the problem that the old world cannot solve.
Yes, sir.
What a mighty God we serve. A lot of people are going into depression right now because of the pandemic, because they've lost their business, because they lost their job.
In their independence.
Yeah. They lost their independence. A lot of them are lonely. You know why they are lonely? Because of dissatisfaction. But the dissatisfaction is because something is missing inside of them.
Jesus.
There's a void inside of them.
Preacher.
All they need to do is to cultivate a closer relationship
That's
with God.
Right.
To cultivate
Come
a
on,
dynamic
sir.
Relationship with God.
Yes.
Where you cultivate a dynamic relationship with God. Hallelujah. There's no loneliness. Hallelujah. You can miss your friend because you haven't seen them in months, but you are not lonely.
That's
we
right.
miss the church folks.
Oh,
we miss our
yes.
family. But guess what? We are not lonely.
That's
God
right.
keep us busy here
yes.
because he give us constant direction.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Wow.
To the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. God is able to do exceedingly and abundantly. There's no hopelessness in God. You are a child of God. You should not feel hopeless.
That's
Hallelujah.
Right.
Turn
right.
that situation to God. You've been looking at it in a human standpoint.
Yes,
it's about
sir.
Time you begin to look at it in God's viewpoint. Hallelujah. To the Lamb of God. Open the door and invite Jehovah to come into that situation.
That's right.
Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Some are depressed, some are oppressed, some want to commit suicide. The devil is a liar.
That's
Glory
right,
to God.
Sir.
We are not lonely. Hallelujah. We serve a mighty God that never sleeps. Oh, yay. Glory. Glory to God. Everything is possible. God is able to do exceedingly and abundantly. No situation is hopeless to God.
That's right.
To man, it could be hopeless, but to God, it's not.
That's
and
right.
that's what Jesus said here. But Jesus looked at them and said to them, because they were discouraged, because
yes.
they were afraid, because they were depressed or oppressed, whatever they are going through, Jesus looked at them. With men, it is impossible.
Yes.
But with God,
oh,
all
come
things.
On now. God Almighty.
All things.
Come on now.
I say all things.
Oh.
Name it. All things
Woo.
Are possible.
My Lord Jesus.
Glory to God. So now, Jesus said this in Mark 10:27. So with men, it is impossible. But with God, all things are possible. So what is our contribution to this? Let's go to Mark 9:23.
Mm-hmm.
That will answer that. Mark 9:23. Oh, please, if you can display that on the screen for me, we got to see this. Mark 9:23 is answering Mark 10:27. Mark 10:27 said, but Jesus looked at them and said, with men it is impossible, but with God, for with God all things are possible. Mm-hmm. Now, then I have a question. I'm asking you a question now, God's people. What is our contribution mm-hmm. to all these things, to what Jesus just said? Mm-hmm. Now, let's go to Mark 9:23. Mark 9:23 says, Jesus said to him, if you can believe.
Come on now.
If you can believe.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to ask you, do you believe?
My God.
Do you believe that all things are possible with God?
Mm-hmm.
Do you believe that Jesus is able to solve your problem?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that Jesus is the author and the finisher of our faith?
Preach it, sir.
Do you believe that Woo! Jesus can heal you?
Yes.
Do you believe that Jesus can deliver
yes,
you?
Sir.
Do you believe that Jesus can sustain you?
Yeah.
Do you believe that Jesus can preserve you?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that Jesus can protect you?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe that Jesus can provide for you?
Yes, sir.
Do you believe all you need to do? Hallelujah. Believe.
That's it.
Believe that That's Jesus it. Is able. That Jesus is able to do exceedingly and abundantly and above all you think. And Jesus will say, if you can believe.
If you can.
It's conditional.
That's right.
If you
yes,
can
sir.
Believe.
That's it.
Let me ask you, and I want you to answer me.
That's it.
Everyone that is viewing me right now, do you believe? Type amen or type I believe. Do you believe?
Jesus.
Type I believe. Do you believe
yes.
that Jesus is able to solve your problem?
Yes.
Do you believe that in God there's no hopelessness? Do you believe in God there's no depression?
That's
Do
it.
You believe in God there's no possession?
Ah.
Do you believe in God there's no suppression? Do you believe in God there's no oppression? Do you believe?
That's
Type,
it.
I believe.
My God in heaven.
I believe. I believe. That's all we need to do.
Yes.
Believe.
Yes.
If you believe, type, I believe.
Yes.
If you believe, type, I believe. Don't just say, type it. Or if you cannot type everything, say, type capital B. I believe that Jesus is able,
That's
hallelujah,
right.
to solve my problem.
That's right.
Jesus is able
yes.
to provide for me.
Yes.
Jesus knows. Depression cannot come in
yes.
because I believe.
That's
I
right.
believe in Jesus.
Yes.
I believe what he said he would do.
Yes.
What he said he would do.
Yes.
I know he's capable of doing it. I have checked his resume. He has never failed.
Ah.
He always provides for
That's
his people.
Right.
Somebody type, I believe. Somebody type, I believe.
Yes.
Somebody type, I believe.
Yes.
He's able to deliver
yes.
you. He's able to heal you.
That's
he's able to sustain you.
That's
he's able to keep you.
That's
he's able to protect
That's
you.
It.
He's able. He's able for you to get that promotion. He's able to give you that job.
Oh,
he's able to give you that business.
On.
I believe. I believe. Woo! I believe. I believe. I believe. I believe. I believe. All you need to do. All you need to do.
Oh,
I believe.
I'm
I believe in Christ Jesus.
Oh my God.
Glory
my God.
To God.
That there's some people who are thinking, well, through God is telling them in this pandemic, you're going to start a business. You're going to start a work for me. You're going to start.
I believe.
Ministry. My God, my God.
I believe.
And guess what you got to do?
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
He said it.
I believe.
I believe it.
And that's what Jesus said. If you can believe.
If you can.
All things.
Hey.
No exception.
None.
All inclusion.
Ah.
If you can believe.
I love it.
All things are possible.
I absolutely love
to
it.
Him. That believes. To him. That I believe Jesus. I believe you are able to do it. I know you're going to do it. You said you're going to do
yes,
it.
Sir.
And I know you're going to do it.
Yes.
I'm not going to doubt you. I'll be praising you while I'm waiting for the breakthrough.
Ah.
I'll be shouting hallelujah. I'll be worshiping you. I'll be serving you. I believe. I believe. I believe.
That's it.
I believe.
I believe.
That's all you got
I
to
believe.
Do. He's able to do it.
Same God.
Oh,
same God back then.
Come
same
on,
God
sing it.
Right now.
Come on,
Glory
sing it, prophet.
God.
Come on, sing
Hallelujah.
It.
Hallelujah.
I believe.
Yes.
I believe.
Yes.
I believe I can fly.
I believe.
I believe I can fly.
Yes.
I believe I can get that job.
I believe I can start a company in this pandemic.
I believe I can start a company in this pandemic.
Yes.
I believe the work of God will continue in this pandemic.
Yes.
I believe the work of God will not start in this pandemic. Somebody type, I believe.
Yes.
I believe. Yes. I believe. I believe. I believe. I believe. I believe.
Yes.
I believe.
Yes.
I believe. Yes. I believe.
Yes.
I believe. I believe. I believe. I believe. Hallelujah.
Yes, yes, yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
To the Lamb of God.
I believe. The economy of earth is not my economy.
I believe.
I believe that I can go and start my ministry.
I believe.
I believe although church doors are closed temporarily.
I believe.
I can still press on with my ministry.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I can start that company.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I can start that $1 million company.
I believe.
Glory to God.
I believe.
I believe it.
I believe.
I believe.
Everything that the Lord said,
that's
I believe.
Right. I believe.
What
it.
God said will do in my life.
Yes.
I believe.
I believe.
What God said is going to do in your life. You better believe.
Yes.
I 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 believe.
Yes.
All you got to do is believe.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
If you believe,
glory
all things are possible.
Oh, hallelujah.
All things are possible to him that believe. To
yes.
him
yes.
that believe.
Yes.
I believe.
Oh, I hear.
I believe the spoken work of God.
Something in the spirit that somebody saying they're watching all the businesses close down, all the companies close down, and it's starting to get to them thinking, oh my God, maybe my business next, or they said that the economy is gonna this and that's gonna happen. You and Lord said you need to believe that your business, your company, you have dedicated your life to me.
I believe
that this economy is not gonna stop your business because your business is my business because you made it my business because you dedicated. Can I get an amen?
I believe. Amen. I believe. I believe. I believe. I have to finish.
Jesus.
I believe.
My God.
I believe.
My God.
Say this. Everything. Every spoken word of God.
Yes.
For my life.
Uh-huh.
I believe.
My God. Say it one more time, please.
Every spoken word of God.
Every spoken word of God.
For my life.
For my life.
For my family.
For my family.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe it.
I believe it.
For everlasting life, I believe.
I believe it for everlasting
life. For my
life.
Global evangelism,
yes.
I believe.
I believe it for my global
from prophetic evangelism. Ministry.
Yes.
Global prophetic ministry.
Yes.
I believe.
I believe it.
For
sir.
Healing ministry.
Yes.
I believe.
I believe, sir.
Every spoken word
yes.
of God. I believe.
Yes.
I believe.
Yes.
I believe.
I believe.
Do you believe?
For a
the left type, I believe.
The
left type, I believe.
Oh, glory to God.
I believe.
God. Hey.
And I declare.
Jesus.
I believe.
Yes.
Oh, I'm stuck here.
Oh, my God. There's some people that, somebody, ooh. there's more than one, that so many people are being laid off their jobs, including maybe their company, and God is saying, you will not be laid off.
Do you believe?
My Lord Jesus.
Type, I believe.
My God.
Psalm 91:2. I have to finish. Oh, Jesus, I thank you. I believe. Glory to God. I believe every spoken word of God.
That's
I believe
right.
every written word of God.
Yes.
I believe the logo.
Oh
I believe
God.
Revelation.
Oh
every spoken
oh
word of
God.
God over my life. I believe over my family. I believe over his church.
Ooh.
I believe over my ministry. I believe.
I believe.
I believe over my businesses. I believe.
Yes.
I believe.
Yes.
I believe.
My,
I believe.
Yes. My economy.
I believe.
Ah. It's not the economy of the earth.
It's divine economy.
Ah,
I believe.
Sir, go ahead.
I believe it's divine economy.
Jesus.
It doesn't matter what's going on with stocks. It doesn't matter.
Oh, you better,
if the economy is crashing.
We have to go there.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I believe God will preserve us.
That's right,
God
sir.
Will protect us.
Yes.
And God will provide for
yes.
us. God will keep us. Hallelujah. And I believe.
I believe it.
I believe it.
Yes.
I believe it.
Yes.
I believe
my
it.
My God, my God, my God, my God.
I believe
God,
it.
My God, my God, my God.
Psalm 91:2. I believe it. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. I want to provoke you to believe.
That's right.
That my God is able
hey!
To do exceedingly
my
and
God,
abundantly.
My God, my
I believe
God.
It. He has done it before.
Ooh.
He can do it again. If he did it before, he can do it again. Again and again and again. I believe it.
Mm.
Glory to God. Psalm 91:2. I want to finish this today. So you can go to the next. Psalm 91:2. I will say to the Lord,
uh-huh.
He is my refuge and fortress. My God, in him I will trust.
Yes.
So you have to believe him. Just trust him.
Yes.
Surrender your life to him.
Mm-hmm.
Stop focusing on human standpoint.
That's it, sir.
Turn around and open the door to hear God's standpoint.
That's it, sir.
That's what David said here. I will say to the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him I will trust. Just trust him. One more point I'm going to give you, and I will conclude this today. The mind, I feel like preaching this again next week.
My Lord Jesus.
But we'll move to the next. There's other messages I have to preach in this dispensation we are in. Personal strongholds. I've told you, we've shared mental strongholds. Now this is personal strongholds. We need to be careful for some things that we say that we don't know what it is, what is causing in our mind. It's called personal stronghold. Like, I am worthless.
God, God Almighty.
Try not to say anything negative about yourself. Even if you mess up, encourage yourself in the Lord.
That's right, as David did.
Like, I am worthless. That's personal stronghold. If you keep on saying it, it will become a stronghold in your mind. I am worthless. I will never succeed at anything. I am dumb. Nobody accepts me. Everybody rejects me. I am always in need of something. I do not have a calling from God.
Yes.
Everybody have a calling.
That's a common one.
That's a common one. I do not have a calling of God. Who tell you that?
That's right.
It's because you haven't discovered it. You have a calling. You have a calling. Amen. Many are called. Everybody is called. Every believer is called. Amen. I'm always in need of something. I do not have a calling. I will never change. I am ugly. I am sick. I am weak. I will never get married because I've been single forever.
The devil.
My only way out is suicide. The devil is a liar. These are called personal strongholds. If you continue to say this, it will be established in your mind. It will be established in your mind. When you begin to say these personal strongholds, you go from personal stronghold to mental strongholds. When those thoughts are established in predisposed mind and impregnated with hopelessness. So we have to be careful. Some things that we say, oh, I wouldn't make it. Or things that we say to our children, to what we say to our children, it can lead to low self-esteem and lead to depression when they get older. Even at this stage, there's depression, youth depression, teen depression, children depression. Those are personal strongholds. I am worthless. I will not succeed in life. Oh, I'm not going to make it. I am dumb. Nobody accepts me. Everybody rejects me. I am always in need of something. I do not have a calling. I'm taking drug or alcohol. I will not change. God can change
That's
you.
Right.
God can deliver you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I will never change. You will change in Jesus' name. In just Jesus' name. I will never get married because I'm old now. I've been single for a long time. Or I will never have children. I have married but no children. Yeah, God can change that. God will change that in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, I'm going to stop here. And let's note all those points. The mental stronghold. No, mental stronghold. We don't want to have that. What contribute to that? argument, imagination, ideas, you know, idiosyncrasy, you know, our mental structure, you know, that leads to mental strongholds.
Mm-hmm.
Amen? And God is able
to
deliver you from stress.
Amen.
Just believe.
Amen.
Amen. Great testimonies coming.
Great testimonies are coming.
Amen. God bless you.
Bless you.
God bless you. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you.
Mm-hmm.
Father, we thank you. We bless you for today's session. Thank you for what you have done. Thank you that we know now that all things are possible for those that didn't know before, that all things are possible to them that believe. And we declare, we believe, Father God, as they sow that seed, let there be shift, because the ark of the covenant is present to catapult, to bless, to deliver, to heal, to set free in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Father, we thank you for today's service.
Yeah.
We pray in the name of Jesus that even Sunday will be even powerful in the name of Jesus. That you will visit us even on Sunday in the name of the Lord God Jesus. We thank you.
Yes, God.
We believe, Lord.
Yes.
We believe you,
Lord. Yes.
Every spoken word of God, we believe.
Oh, Rabbi Saya.
Every written word of God, we believe. We believe for the prophetic word. We believe for the written word. We thank you for what you have begun to do. In Jesus' name, the Lord bless you and keep you.
Mm-hmm.
The Lord be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance, and the Lord give you peace. Let the peace of God that surpasses all understanding, let you guard your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus. And somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. God bless.
Wow.
Bye-bye. 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 Bye-bye.